Hello students, in this video we'll be looking at program 15 of part B of your C programming lab. First let us look at the problem statement. The problem statement says implement recursive functions for binary to decimal conversion. So before understanding the program and how it works, you should have a sound understanding of what is a binary number and what is a decimal number. A number which is having the base 2 is a binary number. That means it can be a combination of just two values, either 0 or 1. And a decimal number is a number which has the base 10. That means it can take any combination of values between 0 to 9. So when you are converting binary to decimal, let us see how do we do it manually. I think you'll have seen this in electronics, and I think you'll have also seen it in computer science theory class how to do it. So this is a binary number, it is to the base 2, and this I'm converting it into the decimal number. So every digit is multiplied by 2, and from right to left we keep on incrementing the power of 2 by 1. So we start with 2 raised to 0 into 2 raised to 1, then 2 raised to 2 and 2 raised to 3. So these values are constant, we just multiply it with 2 powers increasing from right to left. So 2 cube is 8, then 1 into 2 square is 4, then 2 raised to 1 is 2, and then finally here since we have 0, the value will become 0. So the total is 14. So 1110 in binary is equivalent to 14 in decimal. So the same functionality we are going to provide, or the same method we are going to use in the C programming, but the difference is that we'll be using a recursive function. So a recursive function is a function that calls itself. So we know that if there are two functions, the one which is calling is known as the calling function, and the one which is getting called, or the one which is getting invoked, is known as the called function. So here we are using a recursive function to convert binary to decimal. So if we look at the program here, this function that we are going to use, bin underscore t underscore dec, so this is a binary to decimal conversion function, which is a recursive function. And main is again the driver function. So how does it work is, main will accept a number in binary and provide it to the function bin to dec, and this function which will convert binary to decimal will keep on calling itself till it gets all the values, gets a final answer, and that decimal equivalent of the binary n will be sent back to the main where it is getting printed. So this is the flow of the program, or this is how the program works. But before returning the value, the function calls itself multiple times. So this is a recursive function that we are using. So let us look at the program and understand how it works. So these are the two header files that we are using, stdio.h and mat.h. Again, mat.h because we use some of the mathematical functions here. Then stdio.h because we want the printf and scanf to work. So any function will start executing from the main. So if you look at main, then in main we are calling, or we are creating a variable known as n, and the data type is long long. So what is long long is, when you want to store a very big number, in that case we use a data type known as long long. So if you all know that long takes 8 bytes, but if I want to have a value beyond that, because if I take a very big decimal number, then its binary equivalent will be a very big number. If you all see, just 14 to store, we need 4 bits. So if I take a very huge decimal number or a very big binary number, so to store that we need a bigger data type. So that is why the type that we are taking is long long. Again, long long is also written as long long int. It means one and the same. That means I'm taking an integer value which is very big. Then I give a message to the user I say that enter a valid binary number and possibly it should be less than 10 digits. And then when I'm accepting it with the scanf statement, you all can see that the format specifier is %LLD, not just %D, but it is long int. So LLD, and then I'm accepting the number in %N. So after I do this, I have a printf statement where I'm printing %LLD in binary is equal to %D in decimal. So for this %D, I have a variable which is N that I have accepted. But for this, its binary equivalent, I am calling the function binary to dec. So whatever value that I am going to get from this function will be placed here in place of the %D. So once a call goes to binary to dec, so what is the value that I am passing? I am passing the value that is entered by the user. Again, please remember that the input should be in binary. What do you mean by binary? It should be a combination of zeros and ones. You cannot give a decimal number as an input to this function. The input should be a binary number. So from this point, I go to this point. That is, I jump from the function call and I go to the function body. So that is what pictorically I have represented here. So from main, I'm going to the function, and what is the value that I'm sending? I'm sending the binary N. That is binary value which is stored in the variable N. So once I call this function, so if I take an example, let us take an example. The example that I have taken is 1010. So if this is the value of N and I am calling the function, so the value that will go here will also be 1010. The value that I have passed is 1010. The value that is accepted is 1010. Now when I'm sending it, I'm sending it as N, and when I'm accepting it, I'm accepting it as num. So this is your actual variable, this is your formal parameter. So num when I'm accepting, so this num is equivalent to N. So what I do is, first I check whether num divided by 10 is equal to 0. So if I have num divided by 10 and if it is not equal to 0, then I execute these things. If not, I stop. So let us check here. So I have a function call where I'm calling, while I have the N value as 1010. Then what I have to check first is, if 1010 divided by 10, what is the value of 1010 divided by 10? It is 101. And is it not equal to 0? Yes, it is not equal to 0. So this condition what we are looking for is not met. So when this condition will be met? This condition will be met when the value is 0. So 101, if I take a not of it, which will not become true, that means false of it. So this particular condition will become false and we go to the second step. I hope everybody is getting this part, what we are doing here. I told you that the value that we are taking is 101010. So 1010 divided by 10, if I do, I get 101. And if I take a not of it, it will become a zero value, which will become false. So that is why this condition will become false and we are not returning num. So we go to the other statement. So this statement is not executed. So we go to this statement where we are taking the same num, taking the mod of it and again calling the binary to decimal. So if you'll see here, 1010 mod 10 plus binary to decimal with new value. What is the new value? The new value is num divided by 10. So 1010 divided by 10 is 101. This should be again multiplied by 2. So this is again a function call. If I have this function call, again the call will go to the same function that we have written. So here the called function and the calling function are the same. So now again, I am calling the same function but with a new value, which is 101. Again, check whether 101 divided by 10, is it 0? 101 divided by 10, the value will be 10. Not of that, the value will become false. So this condition is not true. So come to this part where again you are calling the same function. So 101 is equal divided by 10 is equal to 10, which is not equal to 0. So the condition becomes false. So here again we call the same function with a new value now, which is 10. So when I do this again, go back, check 10 divided by 10 is equal to 1, which is equal to 0. So this function is already called how many times? If you'll check, this is the first call to the function, second call to the function, third call to the function, and this is the fourth call to the function. So is 1 not equal to 0? No. So till you get the value as 0, you keep on doing the calculations. Once you do the calculations, at some point you will get the value as 0. For example, here I had called it with the value of 10, then 10 divided by 10 is not equal to 0, it is 1. So again I substitute the values here, I get decimal of 1. Now 1 divided by 10 is 0, so I return 1. That is what we are doing here. So that is what this says, return num. The num value that I had got is 1. So substitute 1 here. So when you substitute 1, 1 into 2 plus 10 more 10 is 0. So the value that you will be returning will be 2. Now substitute 2 here, 2 into 2 is 4 plus 1. So the value will that you will be returning is 5. Now 5 into 2, the value is 10. Plus 1010 mod 10, which is again the remainder is 0. So this value will become 10. So the final answer that you will be sending back after the calculation will be 10. So the final answer that will get printed here will be 10. So very important is how you are substituting into the function. So first call, then from the main, and once you start the second call will make the third call to the fourth call. The fourth call will give the result first, then the values are substituted to the second, then second to again the third. So this is how the working of recursive function is, and this is how we are converting the binary value to the decimal value. I hope this video is helpful to you all. If any part you are not understanding, please feel free to ask me. So I'll just show you all how the input will be given. So they say enter a valid binary number. So binary number something like this, if you all are giving, then it will convert it into binary and print it like this. So this is very important. How input you are giving is very important in this program. So I hope this is useful to you and you all have understood. In case of any doubts, please comment in the comment section, or you all can ask me personally. Thank you.